Hey, it's Johnny. This is my reaction to Lana Del Rey's Tropico movie. I'm probably going to post some of this on YouTube, so if I do, the whole thing's on patreon.com/bridgethegapreactions. So head over there for loads more Lana reactions. I'll put some on screen. I'll tell you about it at the end.
And the spirit of John moved upon the face of the waters. And John said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And John saw that it was good.
And Marilyn as well. Wow. Come on, man.
You gotta get on that horse and ride. Don't be afraid. Wear your boots up high, your pants low.
Sex is a part of nature.
Good way.
I go along with nature.
Make sure you do it, Pilgrim, because I'll be watching.
Life can change on a dime. Sometimes you just have to gamble.
Yeah, baby, that's what it is.
Is she Mary or Eve? Fascinating.
Elvis is my daddy, Marilyn's my mother, Jesus is my bestest friend.
I don't know this song.
We don't need nobody, 'cause we got each other. Or at least I pretend. We get down every Friday night, dancing and grinding in the pale moonlight. Grand old I pray, we're feeling alright. Mary prays the rosary for my broken mind. So don't worry about me. I sing the body electric. I sing the body electric.
What a song. Oh, that's so dramatic. That's amazing. That chorus is absolutely incredible. It's so dramatic. The visuals go with it amazingly well. Obviously it's Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve, but she's also dressed as Mary. And I'm not sure what John Wayne, Marilyn Monroe and Elvis are doing there. They're in the song's lyrics, so I get that. But lots to play with. Here we go. That is good editing. That is very good editing. Right.
The voice articulation.
Wow. She looks stunning.
Food, drink, pulse, digestion, sweat, sleep.
Is this poem one of hers? I don't recognize it.
Leaping, reclining, embracing. Arm curving and tightening.
This is amazingly intense.
The skin. Oh, I say, these are not the parts and poems of the body only, but of the soul.
This is a major, major piece of art. Oh, into Gods and Monsters, I think I've seen this bit. Yeah, what a tune. Wow, I saw that without all the lead up to it. Context, I have context.
You got that medicine I need. Fame, liquor, love, give it to me slowly. Put your hands on my waist, do it softly. Me and God, we don't get along, so now I see. No one's gonna
voices of what I truly want. It's innocence lost. When you talk, it's like a movie, and you're making me crazy. Cause life imitates art. If I get a little prettier, can I be your baby? You tell me life isn't that hard.
Just beautiful, stunning piece of work so far. She starts to recite Walt Whitman's I Sing the Body Electric. Okay, so I don't know that one. Okay, we've got Allen Ginsberg's Howl as well. I think I would have recognised Howl. That's the one where he says, like, he's seen the greatest minds of his generation destroyed by... What is it? Destroyed by madness? Destroyed by madness. So maybe that'll be coming up soon, but there's not a lot of artists like as cool as her with such a young fan base that are dishing out Allen Ginsberg and Walt Whitman. That's cool that she's putting that stuff out there.
Just remember, I'm always there for you.
Is he God? Is John Wayne God?
I thought I'd bring somebody here tonight that Jack could
I thought that was Robert Redford for me.
Ladies?
It's got the hair.
I saw the best minds of my generation destroyed by madness.
Ooh.
Starving, hysterical, naked, who ate fire in paint hotels or drank turpentine in Paradise Alley. And so, from being created in his likeness to being banished for wanting to be too much like him. Some poets called it the entrance to the underworld. But on some summer nights, it could feel like paradise.
Are these her words
paradise
now?
Lost.
Have you ever seen a Kansas sunset or Arizona rain?
So are we going to redemption or something else? Baptism? Reborn? Yeah, baptism, okay. So they shed their black clothes, they're now wearing white, which is the... In movies, good guys wear white.
I don't wanna be bad, I won't teach you no more. Roses, Bella, take me there. I've been waiting to meet you. Palm trees.
Okay. Now what's happening?
You're always on my mind.
If you didn't know, I'm a massive Elvis fan. What an incredible piece of work that was. As a massive Elvis fan, I loved all the Elvis bits as well. I'm always happy to see Elvis represented. Like, obviously, he's pretty big anyway. For the record, Val Kilmer as Elvis in True Romance. That's the best. Anyway, back to Lana. That could so easily have been shit. Imagine any other pop star reciting Howl by Allen Ginsberg and imagine how phony it would sound. It was very, very serious, very intense. I loved her as an actor. I thought she was very convincing in the voiceovers and the visual acting. You know, sometimes people just can't act and you can just tell. So story-wise, basically it's like Garden of Eden, fall from grace, you know, loss of innocence, all that. She makes some choices, you know, they're doing various criminal things on Earth. And then that last scene, I saw to be like a baptism, like ascending back into heaven. There's probably more you can read into it, so that's where you come in. You know, tell me what it means to you, tell me all the details that I missed. The attention to detail and the passion and the skill that she puts into it is, you know, it works. It just absolutely works. And incredible songs too. I'd only heard Gods and Monsters before, so it sounds like she's taken a leap forward from Born to Die, which was already good. But these bring in biblical themes, better strings, better beats, better lyrics. Just everything a tiny bit better. Just my opinion, I've not heard the whole EP yet, but you know, for any mainstream artist to put something together like that. First of all, it was very grown up. Swearing, violence, sex. Most people have an image, they have a record company. I mean, she does too. So feedback on that. How does her record company let her get away with stuff like this? I get that she's popular, but everything she does seems like a massive risk. It seems like it could be controversial, could cost lots of money, might not make any back. It seems like she's got the kind of artistic freedom that most artists would kill for, and the funds and the backing. It's just so impressive to see her given that freedom and then see what she does with it. Also, feedback, what this means to you, please comment, let me know. You know, what did you think when this came out? What was your thought? Was it like, yes, I've backed a real one here? You know, first album was great. What's she going to do next? You get this, right. Now we're at the races. Now we've got like a real artist. So yeah, rather than have me go to Google and find out everything about this, you feedback to me what it means to you. Feedback stuff I've missed. I'll watch it again before next weekend and I'll do the Ride EP and maybe give a few more thoughts on this if I've had time to process it a bit more. First impression, first reaction, you've seen that. I love it. It's great. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye.